playing with Starfire. My, how they stare. Let's end this on a high note. None shall tread upon the stars. Never stand in the path of a star. Time to give them a show. It's beyond too late to seek cover. You will know your place. Impending doom. Exciting, isn't it? Congratulations! You have earned my contempt. Lighten up. Destruction needn't be a maudlin affair. Suns never burn for the benefit of dust. Useless and intolerable. Charming. Plenty more to come. Defending yourself? Adorably futile. Tedious being. Boring me is dangerous. I never bite, too uncouth. I'm going to throw a star at you now. Good luck. You are more useful as dust. Too bad. I tried to like you. Nothing a little Starfire cannot fix. Be useful. Be Stardust. I'll help. Why would I spare such mediocrity? You are woefully underprepared. Bravery is absurd, but admirable. Live through this, and we'll chat. I'll indulge your foolhardy nature. Admire, then die. Oh, you will shine. Defenses? Laughable. Be brighter. I'll help. Think cosmic, like this. Not everyone shines brightly enough. Irritating cluster of particles. To atoms! Return to dust. Smolder, then implode! They are merely dust. Illuminate. Melt. What a pity. Dragon's breath it is. Good find. Put it on my tab. The name's Pantheon, with a P. Put it on Mount Targon's tab. Hey, do you know who I am? Just my style. Fine, take your gold. Money? How barbaric. I tend to burn through footwear. My feet rarely touch the ground. Some things are simply better with age. Ages? This thing has been around for centuries, tops. It's been around for ages. So, almost new. All things appreciate in value over time. Hats are always fashionable. As long as it's set at a jaunty angle, I'm in. A snow globe? Perfect for my collect- To destroy you. Destroy you! Shiny, but it's no star. Time to slow things down a bit. A bit gaudy for my taste, but exceedingly useful. Leandri's torment, my benefit. Perfect for the bimillennial celestial masquerade ball. If Bard and Kindred can pull off wearing a mask, so can I. There are no echoes where I'm from. But a shadow of sound. So many magic staves. They call me a comet. They call me a dragon. They have no words for my true form. Cower, worship, beg, they're all valid reactions. In a constantly shifting cosmos, a world this static is refreshing. There simply are no other dragons like me. Never stop when you're on a roll. I shall inscribe this moment in the stars. With a lifespan as comically brief as yours, I suppose I can allow you to taste triumph at least once. I did mean to call you back, but stars needed forging. Terrestrial dragons, a study of flawed constitutions. May I enter? Just joking, star dragons don't need permission. Ah, the joys of lesser organisms rising up to slay their betters. If only they were aware of the impermanence of being, or the permanence of me. You may look forward to more of this. How many must I knock down before they learn? That ought to keep them talking for the next century or so. Cosmic Dragon 5. Everyone else, 0. Please take notes. Well, that was easy. Another mass extinction. So soon. Darling, you have but set my heart free. Starstruck. Wrong orbit. Wrong time. The stars weep for you. Just kidding. I already forgot your name. My wish upon a star came true. Nice job just standing there. Stars are best viewed from a distance. The stars were not in their favor. I guess their fate was written in the stars. All towers fall. It's just what they do when I'm around. Nothing they build can endure like the celestial firmament. Towers tend to crumble when I am in the vicinity. Topple, like all things crafted by mortals. The architects of these towers misunderstand object permanence. Few can impress me. That is a compliment. Which star is your favorite? I made that one. I made the stars, but you inspire me to make more. First, you start with some matter, then add starfire, and voila! It basically does the rest itself. Runeterra. I mean, the name of this world literally means magic earth. I made the stars to illuminate the perpetual nothing, and mortals use them for relationship advice. A sun is unimaginable celestial power, and thrilled mortals use theirs to coordinate this lunchtime. I make entropy look good. Of course I love Runeterra. You have buildings and more buildings. This world holds the key to Targon's undoing. Targon has used me as its weapon for far too long. The heavens diminish without my attention. I would burn the cosmos to catch Targon in the flames. The depths of space crawl with terrible entities. Pray they ignore this world. There are countless colors, but I suppose a single rainbow is a good start. This sun is off its axis. It's been driving me crazy for eons now. Planetary life. The insufferable byproduct of dim stars. Targon's magic is crude, but potent. Nothing kindles wonder like the beauty of stars. Celestial dragons live and die by our own beautiful rules. Love is as real a force as gravity. Try it once in a while. Stars are not born, they are made by me. star's birth is as violent as it is breathtaking. I've waited millennia to watch Targon fall. All beings are made of the same stardust. With a few more basic elements, I could really make this place shimmer. The stars are not to thank for any good luck one may experience. This sun could do with a new core. Any relevant species has been knocked back into the Stone Age once or twice. I wouldn't navigate by the stars. They are a work in progress. Each star is one of my hearts. My works are revered by worlds I have never even visited. Wherever I am is the fashionable part of the universe, even here. Stars are wonder and love ignited. I spark passion into star fire. A star is so much more than a luminous sphere of wonder. If you ask me, we have set the bar too low for sentience. My home is in the cosmos, amongst my stars. The stories they tell about me, they're probably true. All terrestrial dragons are but pale imitations of my kind. Perhaps there is more to this world than I thought. Not much, but enough. As Targon's influence wanes, mine grows. Why does anyone wish upon a star? Planetary life is the accidental byproduct of mildly dim stars. Sometimes the stars gaze back. I kindled the furnaces of wonder. Only when darkness overwhelms the heavens will Targon realize its folly. My stars shine for all. Targon will be the pyre from which I forge a new heaven. I see a universe drained of light and heat, where not even a story will survive. I grieve for every star never born. Darkness is my only true enemy. Whenever I think my work is complete, I end up back here, under this sun. Stars never align for anyone, except me, of course. I am the furnace of wonder. A Crete! Pure starfire! Time to gather the necessary matter. Feels good to make things again. Aim and ignite! Anyone want some stardust? A little dim, but it still works. beautiful. Such a shame. This will be quite the deadly spectacle. And I'm barely trying. Expanding my horizons. Stellar. Time for a great expansion. My sphere of influence grows. Ah. 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 I used to fly amongst the stars. Now I'm down here with you. Your demise will be sung about for ages to come. Only thanks to its proximity to me, of course. Your survival is not impossible, only very, very, very unlikely. I shall be the last thing you see. Lucky you. Make a wish. See if the stars answer. I'll wait. What is the definition of underwhelming? Oh, right. You. I used to wander the stars. Now I'm stuck down here with you. On other worlds, there is emerging life more complex than you. You aspire to be human. Oh, darling, there are so many other variants on mediocrity. I am overwhelmed by an emotion when you are not around. It is called happiness. Mages are infants grasping at the machinery behind reality. At least you have a plausible excuse. You ascended certainly know how to pick an animal totem. Your immortality is but a grain of sand in time's vast desert. Pick a dimension, Bard. You're confusing them. Were you born this flat, or did you work at it? The funnier the hat, the greater the prestige, right? Bruunterra, am I right? You and Leona embody the same light. Typical Targon redundancy. It is always a moon's role to envy the stars. You're out of your league. You would make an interesting dragon. If dunking is the apex of this primitive sport, then I am the queen of space. Made a mistake? Better rewind and repeat until you achieve mediocrity. Fear. Generic. idealism hilariously outdated. Rage. Cute. Gunpowder and metal sticks. Enchanting. Ah, mankind. Ever fumbling from one brink of cataclysm to the next. Humanity. Surprisingly adept in the art of wrestling survival from the clutches of extinction. As far as fauna goes, humans strike a firm middle. I've seen the main act. You're only a third-rate cover band. You do not understand your god, Illaoi. Imagine what you could do with a larger canvas. Life is short. Go crazy once in a while. I get it. Low Dragon. Unfitting of the name. You call yourself a dragon. You're low flame at best. A dragon that still needs wings to fly. Keep trying. You'll get there. The sun. This sun. Oh, darling. You and Diana embody the same light. Typical Targon redundancy. All dazzle, no brilliance. There is a saying on this planet, dumb as a rock. It's not a compliment. You are going to kill me. Just like that? Bravo, Nasus. You've ascended yourself into a dog. Now fetch me something more interesting. I could teach an old dog millions of new tricks, but I simply don't like you, Nasus. Your fate was sealed the moment you picked up Targon's spear. Are you burdened by your own monotony? Because I am. That whole practice of ascension is adorably amusing, like a kitten trying to walk upright. Ah, rise. I see you've brought paper to take notes. True magic is beyond language. Writing merely butchers the intent. Magic tattoos? Where did you get those, magic prison? Oh. Almost interesting. Almost. The dragon's loyalty is a priceless gift. Do not waste it in the service of fools. Medium flame, and that is me being generous. Unfitting of the draconic lineage. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. Do you wonder what you are? The heavens drag on endlessly, much like a conversation with you. The aspect of Targon. Sparks masquerading as lightning. I will cauterize Targon with starfire. You're an aspect. Let me guess. Tackiness. Galaxies exist by my will. But yes, that is certainly an impressive sword. Punching? You are going to punch a Star Dragon. Good luck with that. Blood magic? How tragically primitive. I empathize with your life as a weapon, but have a little backbone. You bend time the way a child folds origami. Cute, but nothing special. Oh, come on, have a little self-respect. Never said I was infallible. Always know when to make an entrance and an exit. I've seen enough. Join me in the dance, Cosmic. Hope, wonder, insignificance. Imagine what they'll feel when I complete the stars. Don't miss me too much. Alas, I am simply too beautiful for this world. Energy never dies. The brightest stars shine on long after they're gone. Let's dance! The stars look very different today. Hello again. Let's have some fun. Left an exquisite corpse. Stars never fall. Hello, Rune Terror. Are you ready to rock? Because I am a Star Dragon, that's why. It's not a comeback if one was never truly gone. Always leave them begging for more.